That's right, Jen. Judge Abramson explained in court today that she watched the case suffer through two lengthy trials filled with painful and graphic testimony, and that now she understands why the state had to, quote, deal with the devil, referring to Billy Marks. So she agreed to Marks' plea deal on the condition that Marks in no way ever profit from his crimes. Billy Marks, looking pale and thin, looks back briefly at his father as he prepares to be sentenced for his role in the murder of Kimberly Cates. Judge Abramson looks disgusted as she addresses the 19-year-old.
You planned and you watched and you celebrated the unspeakable horrors that you inflicted on an innocent mother and child. Just because you testified against your co-defendants, and we call that cooperation, does not mean that there is any redemption for you here today.
James Marks calls out, "I love you," to his son. "I'll call soon," as Billy is escorted out to begin his 30 to 60 year lockup at the New Hampshire State Prison. David Cates and a handful of family and friends were in the front row. Mr. Cates declining to give a statement in court, but asking lead prosecutor Jeff Strelzin to present his thoughts.
Mr. Cates told me that he understands the plea, but he doesn't like it. He has no sympathy for this defendant. He feels that he's getting off light.
James Marks, always willing to answer media questions, admitted it's painful and uncomfortable to sit so close to David Cates.
It's very emotional. I like to go say something to the guy, but, you know, I don't know if he'd be receptive to me.
What would you like to say?
How sorry I am. My family is. My son certainly is.
Then, sentencing time for the uber-polite Quinn Glover, who always answers in sir and ma'am, who prosecutors say had the least to do with the violent attack, and who turned state's witness against his buddies, Gribble and Spader. Glover addressed the judge with the only apology the Cates family has heard in this courtroom.
But every morsel of food that I eat, every breath of air that I take, every beat of my heart, I think of what we have done. I know that there is nothing that I can do. They'll ever atone for my terrible actions.
Billy Marks has been living in the Valley Street Jail in Manchester for the past 18 months. Now he'll be transferred to the New Hampshire State Prison, and his father thinks his life will improve there with some structure and some routine. And this is the end of a very long road for the Cates family. They have not missed a single day of the trial, Mr. Cates calling it his duty as a husband and a father to be there. We're told Mr. Cates will not attend the final sentencing, that of Autumn Savoy. We're live in Nashua, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.